In this chapter, we will discuss how to find out the cost of capital. First, we will discuss how to find out the cost of capital by different sources: cost of equity, cost of debt, cost of preferred stock. Then we will put them all together, figure out weighted average cost of capital, WACC. We will also address how to find out discount rate for divisional and special projects. Lastly, we will discuss flotation costs. What is cost capital? Why do we care? From firm's point of view, cost capital is the cost of raising capital from the market. How much does it cost a firm for every $1 raised from the markets? From investors' point of view, cost capital is expected return from the securities they invested. To convince investors to buy stocks and bonds from the company, how much return does the company have to promise to the investors in return? As you see, these two rates are the same. Return to securities to the investors is the same as the cost of capital of the funds raised by the firm. Cost of capital depends primarily on the use of fund, not the sources. You may think, if Bank A charged me 10% of the loans, if I go to another bank or sell corporate bonds, I might be able to borrow at a cheaper rate. Not necessary. What matters is how firms use the capital efficiently in the investment and make money effectively. Take example of Kmart and Walmart. Which firms use capital more efficiently? Right. Generally speaking, firms with solid earnings and a lower risk are able to raise cheaper funds. Does that make sense to you? Depend on the sources of capital raised. Firms are either financed with all equity, no debt, or a mixture of debt and equity. Let's focus on all equity firms first. A lot of businesses start out with equity finance only. eBay stores, mom and dad shops around the corner. For an all equity firms, as total capital equal to total equity, so cost of capital equal to cost of equity too. Cost of equity is the return required by equity investors given the risk of the cash flow from the firm. That is, cost of equity is expected return on the stocks. Two ways to find out cost of equity. One, dividend growth model. Two, CAPM or SML model. Using dividend growth model rearrange, we found cost of equity is dividend yield plus dividend growth rate. What is D1 in this formula? Is this the dividend just paid or the next coming dividend? Right, D1 is the next coming dividend. If you are given the dividend just paid, you do need to grow one more period by multiply 1 plus G to change into D1. Let's see the following examples. Company is expected to pay a dividend of $1.50 per share next year. Steady growth of 5.1% for dividend growth. Current stock price is $25. What is cost of equity? We will simply plug into the formula. As $1.50 is the next year dividend, so no need to change. The answer is 11.1%. Where is the dividend growth rate from? We can actually estimate from historical data. See below. First, we're going to calculate percentage change every single year. Then we will add up, take average. As you see, dividend growth is quite stable from year to year. Is dividend growth model good for finding cost equity? Advantage is it's easy to understand and use. There are a few issues though. Not every company is paying dividend. Even they do pay dividend, they are not necessarily following a constant growth rate. So, only firms following a constant gross dividend policy are fit for this approach. The outcome is very sensitive to the dividend growth rate. An increase of 1% in dividend growth will directly increase cost equity by 1%. This plot does not address risk directly. Do you see any risk measures such as beta in the formula? The answer is no. Now let's check out alternative approach for cost equity. CAPM model. To use this model, you need information on risk-free, market risk premium, and beta. Suppose the firm's equity beta is 0.58, risk-free 6.1, market risk premium 8.6. So use CAPM model, cost equity is simply 6.1 plus 0.58 times 8.6 equal 11.1%. Notice market risk premium is already 8.6. No need to subtract risk-free anymore. Now, pros and cons of using CAPM model to find the cost equity. CAPM model specifically adjusts for systematic risk, as shown by beta in the formula. In addition, not much restrictions. Almost all public companies with stock exchanged traded in the stock exchanges shall be able to use this approach. Downsides. Both market risk premium and beta need to be estimated. Those numbers tend to change over time. Plus, we are using past data to predict the future, which assume past is going to repeat in the future. Not always reliable. Let's work one more example using both approach. Take out your scratch paper, pen, and a calculator. Let's start. Market risk premium is 9%. Risk-free is 6%. The dividend grow at 6%. The last dividend was $2. Stock is currently selling for $15.65. In this practice, the dividend given is the last dividend. So you do need to grow by one more period. I will ask you to pause the video, work out your numbers before you check the answers. Did you get them both right? Okay, we have done how to find the cost of capital for all equity firms. Basically, set is looking for cost of equity. Now let's turn to firms with a mixture of debt and equity. How to find the cost of debt paid by the company? Two approaches. One is find out yield to maturity of the bonds issued by the company. In the case of multiple bonds, use the weighted average. The other approach is use credit rating. Suppose firm's bond rating is BBB. Find out average rates for BBB bonds. Word of caution, cost of debt is not coupon rate. Never use coupon rate for cost of debt. Here's a table. Lists the bond yield spread by credit ratings and maturity. For example, for BBB bond with 5-year maturity, the average yield spread is 107 basis points, implying the yield maturity on this type of bond is 1.07% plus 1.74% treasury yield, total 2.81%. Let's practice finding yield maturity for corporate bonds. Suppose we have a bond issue currently outstanding is 25 years left maturity. Coupon rate is 9%. The coupons are paid semi-annually. The bond is currently selling for $908,720. What is the cost of debt? For a semi-annual bond, which pays coupon twice a year, we need to adjust for the semi-annual feature in three places. Our core triple effect. One is we have to double the number of coupon payment. Two is to split coupon payment into two halves. Lastly, do not forget to double the interest rate to APR. Here's another practice for cost of debt. Pause the video and try it. Borrowing has advantage as interest expenses are deducted from taxable income. This would bring down the cost of debt. We will call the cost of debt that we calculated previously as a pre-tax cost of debt. We will adjust after-tax effect for after-tax cost of debt. In addition to raise capital through debt and equity, firms sometimes raise capital by selling preferred stock. Preferred stocks typically receive dividend payment every quarter. Firms seldom skip the dividend payment. So the cash flow is a type of perpetuity. We need preferred stock dividend dollar amount and preferred stock price to find out cost of preferred stock. Oftentimes, preferred stock are expressed as percentage of yield. In that case, simply multiply the par value $100 to convert to dollar amount. Quiz. How much is the par value of preferred stock? 100 or 1,000? Let's practice. Your company has preferred stock that has annual dividend yield of 3%. If the current price is $25, what is the cost of preferred stock? Now that we can find out annual dividend amount by 3%, multiplying $100 par value, which is $3, then divide by the stock price, $25, the cost of preferred stock is 12%. Ready to practice on your own? Pause the video and calculate. Did you get the answer right?